The West Sirius has 8 life rafts for emergency evacuation in the event of a disaster aboard the rig. 4 are located port midship under the crane. 4 are located starboard 4 just aft of the anchor windlass. The launching procedure is as follows. The Ned Deck Marine Raft Evert is designed for efficient handling of a life raft with its full complement of people. The Devert is equipped with a manual driven winch and a manual driven slewing system. The winch is equipped with a system for gravity lowering which can be operated from the life raft as well as the deck. The Devert launched Viking 25-man self-righting life raft is designed to be connected to the Devert and then inflated at deck level. The hoisting and lowering instructions are located on the outside of each life raft. The life raft can also be thrown overboard and inflated with a hard pull of the painter line. To launch the raft, when told by the captain to do so, first, pull some slack by having someone push the brake, and then pull down on the hook. You can also turn the hand wheel to pay out some slack. Remove lashings by pulling the red line of the slip hook connected to the hydrostatic release unit. Pull the black flap off the container. Insert the lifting shackle into the hook. Close the hook by pushing the side lever up hard. Remove the crank handle from its cradle and into the hoist. Lift the life raft high enough to clear all obstacles by turning the crank. Tie off the container line to the handrail. This is very important. If the container line is not tied off, the two halves will fall, possibly striking people below. Tie off or have someone hold the bow and stern steering lines. Pull out a shorter mount of painter and tie off at the embarkation deck. Remove the crank handle from the hoist position and insert into slew shaft. Turn davit 90 degrees outboard to line up with the boarding station gate. Inflate the raft by pulling the painter line all the way out until you can pull no more, and then pull sharply. The two halves of the canister should fall away to either side of the rig, being retained by the container retaining lines secured at the rails. you may have to push the brake and lower the raft to even up the raft with the deck. Tension the bowsprit lines to ensure that the life raft is flush against the rig sides. Tie off the bowsprit lines. The person in charge of the life raft should then carry out internal checks on the condition of the buoyancy chambers for any defects. Now that the raft is secured tightly to the rig, open the gate and board the life raft. Load the life raft in a stable manner. Ensure all personnel have no sharp objects in their pockets. When the boarding is complete, untie or cut the bowsprit lines. Cut the painter. A check must be made over the side to ensure that the water is clear beneath the life raft and is safe to launch. Lower the life raft by pulling the brake wire or have someone push the brake lever on the davit. When fully waterborne, pull the red handle sharply on the hook. Viking life rafts are fully equipped with a selection of the highest quality emergency equipment. Emergency pack equipment is designed to keep you as safe and as comfortable as possible in your life raft until help arrives. Life raft components include paddles, parachute rocket signals, hand flares, smoke signals, emergency rations, drinking water, as well as many useful and life-saving items.